Hi and welcome to this tutorial about the basics of using EBSCO article databases. Most of the article databases at the COS Library are from a large database company called EBSCO. There are a couple of nice things about having a group of databases from one company. One is that they pretty much all look and work the same, so if you're comfortable using one EBSCO database, you'll be comfortable using the other ones too. Another nice thing is the Choose Databases link that EBSCO puts over the search box. If I click on Choose Databases, I get a list of all the databases that we currently get from EBSCO. Right now I'm set up to search Academic Search Complete, which is one of our best general databases. It covers a wide variety of topics well, and it's one of our largest article databases. From there, I can add in any other databases I want. I can add in Master File Premier, which is another good general database, or I could add in one of our many subject databases. For example, if I was writing a paper for a psychology class, I might want to be searching in our psychology database. If you can't tell what a database covers, you can click on the text bubble next to the name and read the description to find out what topics it covers. You can add in as many databases as you want, and when you're done, click on the yellow OK button. Now we're searching more than one database at a time. Before we type in a search, I want to point out a few things in the Limit Your Results section. One is the full text box. You want to make sure that the full text box always stays checked. That's what makes sure everything in your search results has the full article attached and ready for you to read. Over on the right-hand side, we've got a box next to Scholarly Peer-Reviewed Journals. If you have an assignment where you're required to use scholarly or academic or peer-reviewed articles, you might want to consider checking that box. If you do, EBSCO will make sure that all of the articles in your search results are from a scholarly or peer-reviewed journal. That can be a little tricky to tell on your own, so it's nice that EBSCO will do the work for you. If you're looking for articles that are published after a certain year or within a certain date range, you can use the publication date feature to set those limits on your search results. Going up to the search box, I'm going to do a search for articles that talk about the impact of poverty on educational levels. Searching in databases is really different than searching in Google. They're set up quite differently. So if you get stuck or have any questions, please contact the COS Library for help or see our website for some of our handouts and other information. Once you've typed in your search, click on the green search button. Here are our results. Over on the left-hand side, we've got a section called Limit 2, and there are a few familiar faces here. We've got the full text box, the scholarly peer-reviewed journals box, and a way to adjust the publication dates of our search results. So if you missed any of those on the first page, know that you can always adjust them from your search results. Our search results take up most of the screen, and they are all structured pretty much the same way. The title of the article is in blue, and it's a link to more details about the article. We'll try that in a minute. Below that, we've got the names of the authors. We've got the name of the journal where the article was published, when it was published, volume and issue number, etc. We have the start of a summary of the article. The whole summary will appear in the full details. We've got subjects, and we've got links to illustrations that are used in the article. If you can tell from this brief bit of information about the article that it's one you want to read, you can click on the full text link right from the screen. Often it's nice though to go to the full details, so I'm going to click on the title of the article and go to the details screen. Again, we've got the title at the top of the screen, we've got our list of authors, and then we've got this line called source. Source is where you're going to find information about the publication of the article, which is often an important thing in a citation, and it can be one of the most confusing elements for people to find in the details. So remember, publication information goes in the line called source. This is where you'll see the title of the journal or the magazine or the newspaper where the article was published, and that appears in blue. You'll have when it was published and other information like volume and issue number and page numbers. Below that, we've got our subject terms. Subject terms are words and phrases that are used over and over again to describe articles that all cover the same topics, so it makes them really good words to search on. In this particular article, we've got the subject term educational attainment, which is a similar idea to educational levels. For this research project, it would be a really good idea to go back and rerun your search as poverty and educational attainment and see if it improved your search results at all. At the very least, you should get some different results and hopefully some good articles that you missed the first time. So below that, we've got our abstract, which is the summary of the article. And going further down is a line called database. For many citation styles, you do need to list the name of the database where you found an article. Because we're searching more than one database at a time, we need to take a quick extra step and see which database this article is from. In this case, Academic Search Complete. Going back up to the top and over to the right sidebar, there's a list of tools. These tools all appear once we open the full text of the article. So I'm going to go to the left sidebar to open the article, and we'll look at those tools in the next screen. So over in the left sidebar, we have a link to full text. Most of the time it will be a PDF full text link, but sometimes it might say HTML full text. Either way, it will open the article up. The whole thing is here, so you'll be able to read the entire article. Over on the right side, we've got our list of tools as promised. The text descriptors are no longer there, so just rest your mouse over each icon to see what it does. The top one says print, and that is what will allow you to print out the article. The next one down is an email function that allows you to email articles to yourself, which can be a handy feature if you're trying to gather a bunch of articles together on one topic. In addition to sending you the article, you're also going to get sent a citation. So it defaults to MLA, but you can use the drop-down menu to choose other styles. All you need to do after you've filled in your information is click on Send, and it will send you a copy of the article. If you don't see it in your inbox, do check your junk folder. Every once in a while, things will end up there. Everyone's favorite tool in this list, however, is the one called Cite. I'm going to click on the Cite tool, and it brings up a list of citations in all different citation styles from AMA to APA to MLA. They're in alphabetical order, so you'll have to scroll down for things like MLA. These are all computer generated, so they are not always perfect, which means you should always check them against your style guide. You can copy and paste them over into your paper. Every once in a while, you will copy formatting in addition to the text, so you want to make sure once you're in your paper, if you're having problems formatting it, just retype the citation. To close the citation window, click on the X in the upper right corner, and you're back to your article. Once you're done reading your article, you've got a couple of options. Over in the left sidebar, you can click on Detailed Record and go back to the detailed record about the article. But I'm going to go to the upper left corner and click on Results List and go back to the results. Right under the search box is a link called Search History. If you've been changing your search around and playing with different options, it's nice to know that EBSCO is storing your search history, so you can always go back to a previous search and view the results of it. To collapse that list back down, I just click Search History again, and it gets it out of the way. If you have any questions at all about using our EBSCO article databases or any of our databases, you should always feel free to contact the library. Believe it or not, we actually enjoy doing research, so if you have any questions, please stop by, call us, or email us. We're always happy to help. Thank you for watching and listening, and happy researching.